supposed to die tonight. Niggas don't put a hit out and they talking like this shit okay. What's good, y'all? Still one of the only NY Phenom, most phenomenal voice in sports. Make sure you hit that like button, and if you're new, go and subscribe to the Phenomenal Crew. Now let's get to it. Listen. Bucks Nation, this hurts, y'all. This hurts. This loss hurts. If you guys can barely hear me, I gotta record low, busy, in a packed area. I gotta record low, but hear me out. That's a tough loss, man. That loss sucks. Hear me out. First thing first, because I know some people are gonna come here and troll and say, Nick Foles owned Brady. Hear me out. This game wasn't an offensive shootout. Nick Foles had one touchdown, 243 yards on 30 completions. The offense didn't do nothing. But all I can say about this game is what could go wrong for the Bucks went wrong. The Bucks had all control of this game. Brady and the Bucks had all control of this game in the first quarter. And like everything was going well until late in the first half. The Bears finally get on the board because the Bucks defense was shutting Nick Foles and the Bears offense down. In the first quarter and early in the first half, they were shutting the Bears down. But they finally get in the end zone. Brady gets the ball back. He throws the ball to this Creshawn Hogan rookie. And the only reason this Creshawn Hogan rookie isn't even in the game is because LeSean McCoy and Leonard Fournette is injured. So he gets in the game, he fumbles. Bears get the ball back, they score again. But it's like the Bucks had this game. They had this game. The Bucks let this game go through their hands. They did. And I get it. It's a short week. You're traveling. It's a short week. Thursday night game really, really goes well for the away team. Thursday night games really goes right for the away team. Really does. But at the end of the day, Brady and the Bucks had this game, y'all. They did. They had this game. They were beating the Bears 14-3 in the first quarter. Late in the first half. And things just went wrong, y'all. Like, forced the interception. Carlton Davis forced the interception. Got the interception. Locking up Allen Robinson. It's not like Allen Robinson dominated this game either. I know he had 10 catches, but it was only for 90 yards. So it's like at the end of the day, the Bucks had this game, y'all. The Bucks had this game. And like I said, what can go wrong will go wrong. When Creshawn Hogan fumbled that ball, all momentum went back to the Bears and Nick Foles. This Bears defensive line was on Brady's ass all day long. They were getting pressure on Brady all game long. Khalil Mack and those boys, and they were all over Brady. It's like this Bucks offensive line is inconsistent. I mean, Brady was getting hit every other play. The Bucks, they were banged up going to this game. They're even more banged up now. It looks like Vita Vea looked bad. Oh my goodness, Vita Vea looked like he broke his ankle. Which, if it looks as bad, if it's as bad as it looks, Vita Vea might be out for the season. And that's unfortunate. Because Vita Vea plays a huge role in this defense. Bucks fans will tell you all about this. One of the reasons why this Bucks defense has been number one versus the run for the past 2 years is because of Vita Vea. So if Vita Vea is out for the entire season, that means you lost your star nose tackle. This is a bad loss, man. Even though this is a very winnable game for the Bears. I get it. The Bears had everything going their way. Like I said, it's a Thursday night game. Nick Foles in his second start. But I just thought Brady would get it done. And it's not like he had opportunity. He had opportunities to get it done. Bruce Arians should have run the ball more. All right, this guy, Ronald Jones. This guy, Ronald Jones, has 106 yards on 17 carries. Against this Bears run defense. why you give Ronald Jones the ball more? Why not? Why can't Ronald Jones get more carries? This guy had six yards per attempt. 6 yards per carry. 6 yards per carry. You can't get in the ball more, Bruce Arians? So it's like at the end of the day, man, it's like the Bucks let this game go through their hands. I get it. The Bucks are dealing with injuries. Chris Godwin out for the game. Leonard Fournette out for the game. LeSean McCoy. OJ Howard out for the season. First game without OJ Howard. Mike Evans is playing banged up. Mike Evans and Scotty Miller is playing banged up. I get it. But this is a game that they were supposed to win, y'all. Now the Bucks are 3-2. And it's not looking good, man. I'm just going to keep it a buck. It's not looking good. No pun intended. No pun intended, man. I really wish Bucks Nation could have got this win. Would have pushed them to 4-1. It was a very winnable game. Man. The Bucks, they play the Packers next. I think that's a home game. It's a home game. Yeah, it's a home game. That Packers game is a must-win game, man. It's a must-win game. You guys can't go 3-3. The Bucks can't go 3-3. They don't need bad momentum. They got to win one of these big games. You let a game go versus the Bears. A very winnable game. The Bears, listen, I know the Bears are 4-1, but they're not unbeatable. They're not a true 4-1 team. I don't look at the Bears any better than what they are now after the win than before. The Bears don't even seem like a legit team to me. I just don't. But at the end of the day, it's like, they won the game. They did. They won the game, even though the refs bailed them out. That roughing the passer, that when Shaq Barrett, what was it? When he put that hit on Nick Foles, that wasn't roughing the passer. Like, come on now. The refs gave the Bears the game. They called a tic-tacky defensive pass interference on Carlton Davis. I mean, it's like the Bears, it's like the refs wanted the Bears to win this game, y'all. They really do. I mean, it's like they wanted to run with the Nick Foles owns Brady narrative. And my thing is, even though the refs bailed the Bears out, this is a game that the Bucks are supposed to win. There's no getting around it. They outplayed themselves. Bruce Arians didn't have a great game coaching. Like I said, if Ronald Jones, if he's running down the Bears' throat like that, you give him the ball 25, 30 times. Especially with the amount of receivers that you have injured. With Chris Godwin injured, with Mike Evans playing banged up, without the first game without OJ Howard, should have run the ball even more. So at the end of the day, it's like the Bucks let this game slip through their hands, man. They let this game slip, and it might cost them, because if the Saints beat the Chargers Monday night, that means the Saints are back on top because they beat the Bucks week one. So at the end of the day, if you're a Bucks fan, all you can hope for is Justin Herbert. He can get shit done in the dome of death, but that's going to be a big task, y'all. That's going to be a big task. So at the end of the day, for the Bucks, biggest concern is get healthy. If you're a Bucks fan, listen, Bucks Nation, hear me out. Y'all biggest concern besides losing this game is getting the players healthy. Y'all need Chris Godwin back healthy. Without Chris Godwin, this offense is incomplete. Guys need to get Mike Evans 100% healthy. This guy Mike Evans has been banged up this entire season. This guy Mike Evans has been banged up since week one. So at the end of the day, can we get a 100% Mike Evans? Can we get Chris Godwin back fully healthy? Can Leonard Fournette come back fully healthy? I mean, we need to get this team fully healthy. Hopefully Vita Vea. It looked bad, y'all. That's all I'm saying. It looked bad. I'm recording this at midnight, so I'm going to try to upload this vid as quickly as possible. But my thing is, things weren't looking that good in Tampa, y'all. Y'all could easily be 4-1 right now. Y'all could easily be 4-1, but y'all let this game slip. And it's disappointing. It's disappointing. It's disappointing in all ways. Brady could have played better. Just overall, y'all could have played better. So at the end of the day, it's unfortunate, but it is what it is, y'all. Prepare for Green Bay. Prepare for Aaron Rodgers. next weekend. Hopefully y'all can be 4-2. But that's all I really got to say, man. That's it, that's all. Subscribe to the channel if you're new. I'm the Phenomenal One, and I'm out. Deuces. Shout out my Crips, they're still crippin', nigga. Shout out my Bloods, they're still bloodin', nigga. Straight from the dirt, shout out my muddy niggas. Came from the bottom, all my get money niggas. When I die, you ain't got to cry, you just got to pray. Put some weed where I lay, I'ma see another day. Full of energy, you my enemy, you got to pay. Was on the east side, fucking with them Crips the other day. Was on the